And we'll be back for the first pitch right after this. Scully Avenue, welcome to Dodger Stadium. Coming up, Game 1 of the World Series on MLB The Show. It's the New York Yankees taking on the Los Angeles Dodgers. John Shambi on play-by-play, Chris Singleton providing the color. There may be no better atmosphere in all of baseball than Game 1 of the Fall Classic, Singy. Lots of excitement to get this thing started.
Yeah, and the players feel that just as much as the fans. You're down there with goosebumps, and these players are just trying to stay in the moment. But I'll tell you, for the home team especially, it's so hard not to be emotional and hyped up with all the energy in this building right now.
And on the other side, of course, you're looking to swing home field advantage your way with an all-important opening win on the road. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. So, almost ready to get underway. Today's starting pitcher, Michael Kopech.
He's a guy that's going to come right after hitters. I mean, he's not trying to fool them. He's going to pitch the contacts, not worry about it. He trusts his defense behind him. And he's not going to mess around with a whole bunch of different offerings. Only three pitches in the repertoire. So he knows he'll have to work in all three effectively and probably pitch backwards sometimes just to make sure this lineup isn't picking up on too many patterns.
One ball, two strikes.
And now it's even up. And downstairs. The pitch. Now fly ball to right center. He's got it. And there's one down. Let's take a look at our lineup. And the key to victory for them here, get their starter some run support early.
Boog, if they can get him that run support early, it's likely the other team folds because they know how dominant he can be once he gets settled in. So put pressure on that other team right away. Jump out to a lead early, and a few runs is going to feel like 30.
Ripped to third and picked on a hop. Hernandez over to first in time. They get the out on Soto. Here is Aaron Judge. So far, the playoffs have not been kind to him, but tonight, a chance to start anew.
So much of this game is mental. He's just got to tell himself, I'm here. I've worked hard all year. Go out, have fun. Trust your ability.
You know, Singy, there are some people that say they feel more pressure actually in the league championship series than the World Series because they know this is it.
I could totally see that because, you know, you get to the World Series, that's what your whole goal was the entire season. Then you're there, there can be some luck involved. So you just got to shake it off, go out there, know that this is a rare opportunity, and just play your best.
99 miles per hour to finish him off. And the Dodgers are coming up to hit no score. This is the World Series on the show. Here at Dodger Stadium. And today's starter, Carlos Rodon.
Well, it comes at hitters with a five-pitch mix, so for him, it's always interesting to see how he utilizes those weapons. He may lean on one or two pitches depending on how things are going and how things are working, but if he can control four or even five of those offerings, look out, hitters. It's going to be a tough day. He's really going to be able to keep those guys off balance.
We go to the bottom of the first, and now here's the Dodgers' designated hitter, Kevin Kiermaier.
Pretty good pitch there to take a rip at. He wants to get his arms extended. He likes the ball away from him a little bit, just not able to square it up.
That one misses. Ball two. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. So a man on base to start the inning. Here's Mookie now. Move to first. Kiermaier back in. And that's off the inside edge. 3-1. And a pitch. Gets the outside corner with that one. Kiermaier gets his lead at first with nobody out. At the belt and fires. Base knock right field. And the postseason success continues for him.
Love how he let that ball travel, trusted his hands. Nice job of going the other way.
Here's Teoscar Hernandez. The pitch. Late with the swing there.
The crowd here has been fired up even before the first pitch for this series, and they'll go crazy right here if they can take an early first inning lead.
A little bit low. First and second, no outs here in game one. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And that is a big first out.
Well, I'm not sure what he was waiting on right there. He got a changeup and still late on it. You rarely see that. It almost makes you think that he was trying to set the pitcher up. I mean, if you can't catch up to the off-speed stuff, there's no way you're going to touch a fastball.
Two on, one out. Tommy Edman steps to the plate for the Dodgers. Fouled off. He was late.
The last thing he wants is to hit the ball on the ground, but I wouldn't expect many pitches up in the zone. They'll be pitching for a double play in this spot.
Breaking ball inside. 2-2. Ripped to right. Should be extra bases. Runner around third. One runs in. Another comes in to score, and they take a two-run lead. And he's at third with one away. That's a triple.
Nicely done. Brings home two. Fastball off the plate a little bit, but a really nice job of going with it. Punched it to the opposite field for that knock.
Third, Max Muncy now at the plate. The count 2-1. And that one fouled off. One away with a runner at third here in game one of the World Series. Swings and misses, struck him out.
Well, I think he was waiting on the changeup right there, and he got it. It just drifted too far in on him. I think that pitch is just a little more out over the plate. Probably squares it up, but instead, he's going to have to go take a seat.
Here's Kike Hernandez. Fastball for a strike. Runner at third, two away. Got him looking. Good job at damage control right there. And welcome back to the ballpark. Here's Stanton now.
These fans have to feel good right about now. This series is not going to be easy, but they have the lead at home in game one. That brings the anxiety down a few notches.
1-1 now.
Right through there for a strike. One wonderful thing about the postseason, you never know who's going to be the hero. It could be the superstar, but often it's a far more unlikely player.
Got him. What a way. Jazz Chisholm Jr. stepping in now for the Yankees. And another ball. You know, one unlikely postseason hero I saw close, Alex Gonzalez of the Marlins in the 2003 World Series. Wasn't really known for his bat, but he hit a walk-off homer in extra innings in Game 4. It tied the series and was a huge momentum swing. He swings and fouls one off. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. And there's two down. Off to a strong start, Singy, as he's punched out three of the first five he's faced.
Well, he's definitely minimizing contact. He can get the swing and miss when he needs it, but it'll also keep the defense fresh behind him, allowing some balls in play as well.
The 1-2. And misses inside. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And it's a 1-2-3 inning. Yanks held in check. They trail it here 2-0. Back here in L.A., bottom half of inning number 2. And here's the rookie center fielder, Andy Pajas. That misses the zone. Now two balls and a strike. Singy wasn't very sharp in the first. Got hit around a little bit. Just wasn't able to locate particularly well. A lot of stuff in the fat part of the plate.
Yeah, Boog, he wasn't fooling anyone. It's a tough place to be because it's not always obvious what adjustments need to be made. Sometimes it's location. Sometimes it's being too predictable. Sometimes you're tipping your pitches. He's going to need to figure it out quickly.
The catcher.
And up to the plate is Will Smith. Ball to strike. The pitch. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two.
One ball.
One out. Base is empty. Swings and misses. It's a strikeout. Pulled the string on the changeup.
Well, that's always the key to effective pitching is getting ahead in the count. And as a pitcher, it really allows you to start expanding the zone. Hitters become defensive, and all of a sudden that plate starts to get really wide. And what happens is, because of the pressure, you end up committing to a pitch as a batter before you recognize what it is, and that's what leads to the strikeout.
Just off the inside edge. Here's a rip to short, but he's there for the third out. Dodgers down in order as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. And we're back on to the third inning. And stepping in for the Yankees, Anthony Volpe. And the pitch. And that's off the inside edge. And that's ball two. Righty to the plate. That one in triple digits. Gets under it and pops it up. Betts on the move. He's got it. And there's one away. Here's the Yankees catcher now, Austin Wells. The wind of the pitch. And that's ripped into left. Base hit.
Everything came together for him. Just a really nice approach to shoot that line drive to the opposite field. There's a lot of hard work and discipline that goes into getting a result like that at the plate. Doesn't come naturally for most hitters.
Here's Alex Verdugo. Little chopper rolls foul.
The healthy cut. Tough pitch at 98. But a really good pass at the ball.
He goes down looking.
Well, just couldn't pull the trigger on the fastball right there, and I don't think he was taking it, thinking it might be a called ball or anything. I just think he was flat out frozen. Did not expect that location, in my opinion.
Foul ball. Kicks and fires. Gets a piece and stays alive. Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout. One left for the Yankees. They're still down. It's 2-0. Back here at Chavez Ravine, bottom of the inning. Here's Kevin Kiermaier.
Designated hitter, Kevin Kiermaier.
And the pitch. And that's outside.
You know, these Dodgers showing great discipline at the plate, and patience definitely seems to be the name of their game in this one. They're doing a good job of working the pitch count, and they've been able to push a couple of runs across to score as well. Still relatively early, but with a pair of runs already on the board, the ripple effect of that high pitch count might set them up to do more damage later in this game.
Rodon ready. Here comes. Swing and a miss. Struck him out.
Now, there's a small sigh of relief right there. I mean, just to keep that speed off the base pass, it's not just the pitcher. It's other guys that have to think about it. From your infielders, have to think about that runner potentially stealing, but also be in position to make a play. As an outfielder, you're thinking about a base hit to the outfield. I got to get to it quickly to try to keep this guy from taking an extra base. So I think everyone just a little more relaxed that he didn't reach base.
Outside pitch got the better of him that time.
Tasked with 1, 2, and 3 to start this inning, but no trouble so far. I'm sure he'd love to strike out the side here. Make a little statement, but you got to be composed in this spot. Focus on getting this next guy. You got 2 good outs. Want to get the third one and avoid the middle of that lineup coming up with a base runner. Could become dangerous.
2 outs. And another ball. Got him looking. And it's a 3-up, 3-down inning. Nothing doing for the Dodgers here, but they're on top 2-0. Back here at Dodger Stadium, John Ciambi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Juan Soto. Wide the kick and the 1-2. The punch out there. Looks like he's picked up right where he left off.
Quite the start to this game on the mound. Looking very dangerous to these hitters. 7 punch outs already. So this lineup hasn't had much success trying to figure him out. I'm impressed with what we're seeing here.
Base is empty, 1 away. Top half of inning number 4. The 1-1 is fouled off. Right-hander kicks, deals. Foul ball still, 1-2 count. Slider misses outside. And down on strikes. Now two out. Giancarlo Stanton to the plate now. Strike on the inside corner, and it's one and two. Swings and misses, and good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. 1-2-3 go the Yankees. They trail things here 2-0. Game one of the World Series. Here's the shortstop at the plate, Tommy Edman. The pitch. That one pushed foul. Into center. Judge is there and puts the squeeze on that one. And there's one away.
Up next to the dog.
And now it's Max Muncy. And here it comes. And a swing and a miss there. But it was bumpy in the early going for the lefty, but he settled into a really nice groove. Good eye in that spot.
It's a good take.
Next offering upstairs. Payoff pitch. Stays alive. A sliding stop. Fires to first, and they get the out.
Just so impressed with the movement on that play. Footwork was excellent. The arm strength was there. And, of course, the most important part was getting the out.
Two outs, bases empty. Kike Hernandez will hit next. Two down, nobody on. Pitch in the dirt. And a count 2-1. Two outs. In the air, right field. Stanton tracks it down for the out. Back here in LA, now the third baseman, Jazz Chisholm Jr. Left-hand batter waits.
There's a good feel in the ballpark, and that's what you expect when the home side has the lead in game one. This energy is going to keep building with every out. Well, we call that key holding. Even though it's right there and looks pretty good, if he doesn't love it, he's not going to swing that early in the count.
That one ripped. Betts ranging back. And that is gone. He circles the bases, and they're on the board. It's 2-1.
That one was a hanger, and pitchers typically don't get away with making a mistake like that. And right there, he made him pay.
And here is Anthony Rizzo. Pulls that one foul. The 1-2. Fights it off. He'll see another. Nobody on, nobody out. And we're at the top of the fifth. That one ran inside, almost got him. Righty delivers. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Got it by him for the play.
Well, Berg, I'll tell you, when he goes to look at the video of that pitch, he's going to want to punch himself. That slider had hit me written all over it, and clearly he just got a little too excited and was out in front. Tell you what, when you get a pitch like that, you cannot miss it. Those have a chance to go a long way.
And here comes the Dodgers manager to the mound. Pitching change coming. Michael Kopech out of the game. Only two hits allowed for him, so a great effort. And we'll be back after a quick break to tell you about the new arm. So the Dodgers have a new arm on the mound, Shohei Ohtani.
And this is an important part of this game. Tight score and still a lot of outs to get. So they're looking for a big outing out of him right here to get some critical outs.
Now it's the shortstop, Anthony Volpe. And a pitch. Fought off foul. Got him swinging. Had him way out front of the slurve.
He had him out in front, which isn't easy to do against a hitter like this, known for using the entire field. Just couldn't sit back long enough on that one.
Here's the catcher, Austin Wells. The pitch. Inside, almost got him. Two outs, base is empty. Next pitch, not close, up high. There's a strike. And down on strikes he goes. Third out, and that ends the frame. Only one hit in the inning, a solo homer, and it's a one-run game. Last half of the fifth coming up. It's the Dodgers 2 and the Yankees 1. We head to the bottom of the fifth. Stepping in, Andy Páez.
Well, you got to give him credit out there on the mound. This outing started off a little shaky, but he's found a way to settle in and turn this into a pretty good start. That shows you a lot about his mental makeup as a pitcher.
Movement in the Yankees pen. Luis Gil appears to be getting loose. Cousins getting loose as well. The pitch. A swing and a miss as he chases way out of the zone. Down and in, moved his feet. And there's a rocket into the outfield. Makes the turn and heads for second. And he's got a leadoff double.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
Will Smith getting ready to hit. Rodon sets and deals. And that one is in the dirt. And that's ball three. Rodon fires. And ball four, two aboard.
He's making things difficult for himself right now out there on the mound. But, you know, his confidence should still be high enough to get out of this. But he's going to have to buckle down right here.
Here comes Chris Taylor. Here comes a pitch. Check swing. He went too far, and it's a strike. Yep. The pitch. Good job to fight that one off. And a pitch. Swing and a miss. Had him out front for the strikeout. And here comes the Yankees manager to the mound. Pitching change coming. Carlos Rodon is done in this one. And they trail as he exits, but he kept them close. A new arm will be on the mound after the break. Luis Gil comes on now.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
So the lineup flips over, and at the plate for the Dodgers, Kevin Kiermaier. Two on, one out.
Well, now that this is a bullpen game, it's clear that whichever bullpen steps up the most is likely going to come away with the W.
And a good eye there.
At the dish, looking to lift the ball in the air in this spot. Anything but the inning double play, Boo.
Mookie Betts hitting on deck circle. That pitch gets the corner. Full count now. Páez, the lead runner at second. Smith at first. One gone. Inside ball four.
Well, the stage has been set for this offense, Boo. It's all about creating opportunities, and this is one of them right here.
Here's Mookie now. Game one of the World Series here tonight, and all he's hoping is that the success that he's had in the first couple of rounds continues.
The great thing, you're here in the World Series. Now just try to have fun. The performance has been outstanding, and why should it stop now?
How do they cool him off?
Well, they're going to be extremely careful with him. I doubt he's going to get much to hit today, but when he does, be careful because he can hit it a long way.
Got him looking. Huge strikeout there. Teoscar Hernandez steps to the plate for the Dodgers. All loaded up. Dangerous hitter at the plate.
Boog, in situations like these, the air can get really thin up there at the plate. Got to find a way to breathe and slow everything down.
Two outs. And fouled off.
Instead of letting the hitter get his arms extended, tied him up a little bit, slightly up, slightly in.
The 2-2. Got him swinging for the strikeout. Slider got him for strike three. And the Dodgers leave him loaded, but they still lead it 2-1. And welcome back to the ballpark. Top of the sixth inning, and stepping in for the Yankees, Alex Verdugo. Left-hand hitter waits. Fights that one away, still 1-2. Right-handed reliever knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. The 1-2 spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another.
Also really good at bat. What I like about this guy, his bat stays in the zone for a long time. Gives him the ability to foul off tough pitches.
Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. And the righty deals. Got him swinging. Back to the top of the Yankee order. Gleyber Torres up to hit. Gleyber Torres. And the right-hander deals. So now 1-2.
Well, that's that slope right there. He's doing extremely well. Talk about just a ton of breaks. So tough to get that barrel to.
At the belt and fires. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout. Here's Juan Soto. He's a guy who does it all. With the lack of contact in today's game, this guy hits for contact, so he delivers average, but there's on-base and slugging too. Hit pretty well in the air out to center. In position. Makes the catch, inning over. So no runs, no hits, no errors, and no one left. To the bottom of the six we go. 4-5-6 coming up. It's the Dodgers 2 and the Yankees 1. And we're back. Leading bottom of the six. Tommy Edman at the plate.
The shortstop. Tommy Edman.
And he deals. And that one fouled off. And a 1-2. The shortstop takes the ball. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
Well, you see him trying to pull that inside pitch right there, and that's not the kind of approach that you want to have. Even if you do get to it, it's going to be very difficult to keep it fair. You're just going to make it a long strike at best. You have to be able to stay within the baseball on the inside of that path to it, and that way, if you're a little quick, the ball gets hit hard somewhere, and it's not foul.
Swings and misses, struck him out. Two outs, base is empty. Here's the third baseman, Enrique Hernandez. Two down, nobody on. That's off the mark, and the count's full. That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. Two down, nobody on. Here in the bottom of the sixth. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Dodgers go down quietly as they're unable to add to their 2-1 lead. New pitcher for the Dodgers, Blake Treinen.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
Yeah, the hard-throwing righty trying to secure these outs against a potent Yankee lineup, and it starts with Aaron Judge. Bounced up the middle, Edman. Judge out of the play.
Those plays can be tricky. They're routine, but that doesn't mean it's always going to be smooth. He delivered a good play right there.
Giancarlo Stanton at the plate. Trying to hold a one-run lead here in the late stages of game one. Next pitch misses way outside. Movement in the bullpen. Daniel Hudson looks to be getting ready for manager Dave Roberts. Phillips also throwing. Looking to get the tying run on base. This ball's chopped on the ground. Toss to Muncy, and that quickly two away.
Hey man, four pitches, two outs. That is an excellent base.
Jazz Chisholm Jr. stepping in now for the Yankees. And another ball. holding on to a one-run lead here in the top half of inning number 7. That one fouled off, 2-2. And a pitch. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And that'll do it. Got an order, go to Yankees. And they trail it here, 2-1. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the 7th. Jake Cousins. Andy Pahez steps to the plate for the Dodgers.
The center fielder, Andy Pahez.
Here's a 1-1. And it's fouled away. Riding to the plate. Line drive to short and caught.
Well, baseball can be cruel, can it? I mean, sometimes it gives and sometimes it takes away. He did everything right on that swing, but he's got nothing to show for it.
Will Smith, the next to hit. Base is empty, one away. Here at the bottom of the 7th. Tied him up inside with that one.
Big time jam right there. I hate it as a hitter, but standing in center field, you can't help but chuckle a little bit.
One down, base is empty. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout.
You know, Boog, you often think of sliders more for that horizontal movement, but most of the good ones have both vertical depth and that horizontal movement, and that's what we saw right there. Good drop on the break and got him to swing over the top.
Here comes Chris Taylor. Swings through that one.
One ball, two strikes.
Two outs. And that one off the outside edge.
Really good slider. He's up there just hoping that it ends up off the plate away.
Struck him out looking. Dodgers down in order. They lead it 2-1. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the 8th. Daniel Hudson.
Now pitching for the Dodgers, number 41, Daniel Hudson.
Well, one run game. Anthony Rizzo steps to the plate.
Anthony Rizzo.
Right-hander kicks, deals. In for a strike. And a count, 1-2. Activity in the bullpen for the Dodgers. Roy Geronimo looks to be getting ready for manager Dave Roberts. And another ball.
Pretty big strikeout right there to start this 8th inning. Down one. Any leadoff base runner really makes this inning a bit more interesting. But now this offense has to switch from possibly trying to manufacture a run to needing to run into something or just try to string multiple hits together to get a run across the plate.
two down here in the top of the eighth.
Well, this is exactly what you're looking for from your bullpen arm when you roll them out there to start a new inning, hold on to a small lead. Just such a stabilizing effect. And not only get the first two hitters, but to strike them out. That gives everyone on defense a big boost of confidence.
Austin Wells stepping in now for the Yankees. The pitch. Down the line. He's got it. And that is that. Now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Tim Mazza.
And they felt it was time to bring on a left-handed reliever from the pen with the lefty hitter coming up.
I think it's a good move.
I know I never liked when opposing teams did that to me.
So the batting order turns over, and here is Kevin Kiermaier.
Kevin Kiermaier.
The 1-2. Popped up. Drifts towards it. He makes the grab. One up, one down.
Now batter, the right fielder, Mookie.
And now it's Mookie Betts. Base is empty, one away. Here the bottom half of the eighth inning. And a 2-1 hammered but foul. Tap dances out of the way of that one. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. Bounce to the left side. Fires across the diamond. Two up, two down.
Now batting, left fielder, payoff curve, Hernandez.
Two outs, base is empty. And next for L.A., Teoscar Hernandez. And it is 2-1. Wouldn't chase that time. And there's ball four.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted in first base with a quick free pass.
Mark Leiter Jr. on a pitch here.
Now pitching for the Yankees. Number 38. Mark Leiter Jr.
Now it's the Dodger cleanup hitter, Tommy Edman. Next offering is in for a strike.
No need to offer that pitch until you get to two strikes. It's just a low percentage of success when you want to try to go after that down and away pitch.
Two outs. Hard ground ball, base knock. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feeling. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
Here's Muncy to hit. Swings through that one for strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
And here it comes. Fouls it off, still 1-2. Hernandez on second. Edmund on at first with two down. Base hit center field. Around third. He'll score. It's 3-1.
Picks himself up an RBI. I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
First and second, two down. Kike Hernandez steps to the plate for the Dodgers. Two on, two outs. And there's a foul ball. One and two here. That one sizzling on its way through to the outfield. Now a long throw home. It's off the mark and he scores. And they're up by three.
That's three singles in a row. There's nothing cheap about the way he got that one through the infield. That was ripped. Caught out in front and didn't get under it like he would have liked, but definitely put a good swing on it.
So two on with two away. Andy Pajes steps to the plate for the Dodgers. The 3-1. Swings through that one out in front that time. 3-2. Got him looking. And that'll keep more runs from coming in. Inning over. We're back. It's the top of the ninth. And there's a new pitcher on the mound. Roy Geronimo.
I think closer has to be one of the toughest jobs in baseball, and we see a pretty high turnover rate because of it. Every outing seems to be high pressure, this one included. We'll see if he can wrap up the win and get himself a save.
Bounce to third. Hernandez over to first in time, and they get the leadoff man in the ninth. The Yankees looking to rally. Back to the top of the lineup. Here's Gleyber Torres. And now the count, 1-2 after the swing and the miss.
It's been tough for the offense so far, but you can't get frustrated. You got to find a way to shake it off, go up there, and relax. That's the only way you're going to be able to put runs up on the board.
And that one missing low. The Dodgers trying to close out a three-run lead here at the top of the ninth. Out to center, Pajes settles under this one and makes the grab. And there's two away. So last chance for the Yankees. Now the number two hitter, Juan Soto. The Yankees down to their final strike. Foul ball still, 1-2 count. Two down, nobody on. Fights that one away, still 1-2. A line in the pitch. That delivers outside. Line drive, and that should be extra bases. Around first, heading for two. And he'll pull in there with a stand-up double.
That's tremendous fight from him, and I know it's got the dugout fired up down there. Down to the last strike, and he comes up with a hit to keep the game alive. It ain't over yet.
And now big number 99, Aaron Judge. And that's outside. 2-1. Runner at second, 2 down. Now this is in the air down the line. Betts sizing this one up. He'll squeeze it for the final out. And